want to make a challenge for you in your backyard, big tough guy. I'm here. I'm not leaving until you and I get in the ring.
The title is on a man. It ain't on some old punk kid like that Kendo Windham.
Whoa! Wait a minute. Hold up. Hold up.
This is Championship Wrestling from Florida. And now, the award-winning voice of Championship Wrestling is chosen by the Florida Sportscasters Association, Gordon Solie.
You're watching right now a Florida Heavyweight Championship match. The Florida Heavyweight Champion, Kendall Windham, moving out against the Cowboy, Ron Bass, the challenger. And may I tell you, at this particular time, Kendall Windham fighting gallantly here. But in a moment, things are going to change. Cowboy Ron Bass has ended up with a very, very cloudy issue surrounding that Florida Heavyweight Championship. And there he goes for that stampede, but you can see Kendall Windham being catapulted into the referee. And what ensued from that point on certainly casts a doubt on the Florida Heavyweight Championship. But at the moment, Cowboy Ron Bass is indeed the new Florida Heavyweight Champion. However, we're going to bring you the balance of that video a little bit later on in the program, and we'll explain to you at that time all of the doubt involved. Welcome to Championship Wrestling 86. Buddy Cole has joined me, and Buddy, we've got an action-packed show, I believe, today.
Boy, you bet we do. You know, one of the big matches today, we have an international wrestling star that goes as the superstar is going to be here today. And he is going up against Son Royal. Now, Son Royal has an unblemished record here on Championship Wrestling from Florida. And this will be a big test for Son Royal. Then later on today, you'll be seeing Cowboy Ron Bass and Ed the Bull Gantner and tag team action together. And it's just a great wrestling program lined up today.
We have indeed. By the way, we might point out, too, that there will be a rematch tonight in Sarasota at Robarts Arena for the Florida Heavyweight Championship between Kendall Windham and Cowboy Ron Bass. Right now, it gives me an extreme amount of pleasure to welcome back to Florida, after a successful trip to the U.S. Heavyweight Tag Team Championship Tournament, the new U.S. Heavyweight Tag Team Champions, the fabulous ones, Stan Lane and Steve Kern. Gentlemen, congratulations.
Thank you very much, Gordon.
Thank you, Gordon.
Congratulations,
everybody.
It's always a pleasure to be on your show, as you know, but it's even a greater pleasure for us, Gordon, to go out there and accomplish something that we've worked so hard for. You know, the last time we did this, went to a tournament in New Orleans, we came back as losers. I hate to say that, but this time we were successful. All the hard work and fortitude paid off, and we're just darn happy to be here.
I'll tell you what, that must be a great high feeling.
Well, it is, Gordon, but you know, speaking of high, I'd like to also bring up something. You know, as I look out here in the TV audience, and every time we step into the arenas, we see so many kids who are such fans, and they look up to the wrestlers and they look up to the sports images, you know. It doesn't take but a few seconds to get to the kids and talk to the kids. And if we can't do anything else, we'd like to talk to a lot of the young kids about a lot of the hard drugs that seem to be going around the state of Florida and the whole United States. You know, they had this Just Say No program for so long, and all the police and everybody have really been pushing hard to try to clean up probably the drug programs. But, you know, there's a drug out right now that is supposed to be so hard and so self-addicting that they're not even sure how long it takes to be addicted to it, but it's one of the hardest drugs out. And the street name, they say, is called crack. Now, I know a lot of you kids out there watching or listening, and you're listening hard. So let us tell you something. If it's anything, first, the best advice we can give you is whenever anybody tries to push any drugs on you or are interested in dealing drugs, just say no. It's a simple answer. Just say no. But be sure that nobody tries to get you to take anything, even if they say it's not a drug. Remember, there's a drug out there right now that causes your lungs to explode. It causes a lot of brain damage and things. And remember, kids, be tough. Stick up for yourself and just say no. Thank you, Gordon.
Thank you, gentlemen. And again, my congratulations to both of you. By the way, Bill Apter, senior editor for Pro Wrestling Illustrated and Wrestler and the Wrestling Annual, will be our special guest a little bit later on. We do have some interesting information regarding those contract negotiations we discussed last week concerning Bob Roop. And we'll be back with the masked superstar going up against Son Royal right after we pause.
Our opening match is one ball with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, to my right, from Tampa, Florida, he weighs in at 232 pounds, here's Sean Royal. His opponent, to my left, hails from Atlanta, Georgia. He weighs in at 272 pounds. He's internationally known as the Masked Superstar. This match is one ball with a 10-minute time limit.
All right, and so the Masked Superstar moving out against Sean Royal. One fall with a 10-minute time limit. Sean Royal facing a real, real tough challenge here. There's the bell. The Masked Superstar who travels internationally constantly. And win, lose, or draw, I want to have a chat with him to find out exactly what did bring him to Florida. Good clean break by the superstar. Sean Royal was tense, set, and alert. Very quickly, it's the superstar, the master of the Cobra Hold, taking Sean Royal to the canvas, getting a rear chin lock. And for the moment, the superstar seems to be completely in charge.
Well, the superstar, of course, being internationally acclaimed as one of the greatest wrestlers in the, not just the United States, but around the world. He's traveled extensively. You can tell by the way he walks that he's very wary. He's ring-wise, always watching his opponent. Right now, Sean Royal has the headlock on the superstar, but there's the superstar is able to turn it into his own advantage very quickly. Many times, you can take a headlock and use it against the person that might have the hold on you. And right, well, he's trying to pull him off. He has his chin there and putting a little pressure on. A headlock is not by any means a submission hold. It can be a punishing hold, but the superstar is able to use this to his own advantage. Now he's holding on to tights there, giving a little extra leverage. Sean Royal hanging on, but not doing any real damage.
All right, now the superstar cross-facing on, and Sean Royal was able to break that away. And now the superstar with short jolting forearms into the thoracic area of the back. And so Sean Royal wants to move away from that possibility, gets back to his feet. And into those ring ropes once again. And notice the way the superstar kept him well cornered. But a good clean break once again by the superstar. Sean Royal stalking his man. Royal in the blue trunks. They lock up collar and elbow, and it's the superstar getting the side headlock now on Sean Royal. By the way, good shoulder smash by the superstar. We have an interesting segment coming up after this match is over, and you'll be seeing the ninja in action, and I'll tell you more about that when we get to it, about some legal action that's been taken. And so it is Sean Royal now with a head scissors on the superstar. I was talking to Harold Nepple Spruth up in Port Richey the other day and told him that the superstar was coming in, and they said, truly one of the classic wrestlers of all time.
That's right, he truly is a classic wrestler. But I'll tell you right now, Sean Royal has the advantage on the superstar. Sean Royal has been holding his own quite effectively here, and right back to his feet, Sean Royal keeping his eye on the superstar. He's been well trained by the Matsuda School of Wrestling, one of the toughest schools of wrestling in the world. Sean Royal knows that you keep your eye on your opponent all the time. Never relax. Now you see with this hip lock takeover there, the superstar putting his weight across the upper chest, but it was slightly off balance. Sean Royal able to come back up with that head scissors once again.
Superstar complaining about the possibility that Sean Royal had pulled at that mask, but I certainly didn't see any evidence of that whatsoever. And it is a superstar now trying to work his way loose. Sean Royal clamping down, and the superstar still trying to work his way out. He's cutting off some of that supply of air, and now superstar turns into his man and slips away from it. And Royal looking at him, and he's complaining about the mask being pulled rather vehemently to the referee. And tell you what, when he makes a point, he makes a point.
Yes, he does. You know, so far in this match, it's been pretty even, kind of back and forth. Neither wrestler doing any serious damage on the other. Both men having a lot of respect for one another, doing the best to make the, have the other wrestler make the first mistake, and if that might have been a mistake on the part of Sean Royal, expecting the superstar to break cleanly, going through the ropes on the floor, and I tell you, that is a solid concrete floor, not even a wooden board on that floor. And it's the fall that hurts.
The superstar putting the boots to the side of the ribcage and up around the shoulder of Sean Royal. He'd like to see that 10 count. That would make it a pretty easy victory for him. And now, no, sir, he's bringing him back. And Royal dumped rather ignominiously outside the ring. As Buddy was mentioning, that's hard concrete out there. And again, the superstar coming out of the ring, gets him into a bear hug, jams him up against the ring apron. And that's really got to put some pain and pressure on the lumbar area back. And again, the superstar now really beginning to uncork with some hard, hard elbows. And now Sean Royal in a world of hurt. As the superstar, I think, was just feeling him out all the way.
Well, yeah, right now it looks like the superstar is, what you might say, going to work. He sees that he has his opponent down and in trouble. He's going to take full advantage. The referee might momentarily break, but you can be assured the superstar will not give Sean Royal a chance to recover from this onslaught. The superstar, he's going for the kill.
Roll body, hey, Sean Royal rolls to one side. Sean Royal moves up, beautiful drop kick by Royal. Royal comes up, another great drop kick. Sean Royal has the international superstar. Down to the canvas, catches him again, another hard right hand. And it's Royal coming up, tried a cross body block. Look at that power slam. Brother, he got a three count, caught him. Sean Royal tried that cross body block, and the superstar caught him, power slammed him, stung a bit. Wait a minute, he's going for the Cobra. He's gone for the Cobra hold. He's already beat the man. Now he's going for the Cobra. And he's clamping down on it. And the referee obviously threatening to reverse that decision. And now Bill Alfonso, our chief referee out there, warning him that he stands a threat of having that decision reversed. But he did finally release it. Let me see if I can get the superstar over here for just a moment and talk to him. As I said, of course, I've watched this man compete all over the world. And Sean Royal certainly gave a good acquittal of himself. May I just say welcome to Florida.
Thank you very much, Gordon. I'm glad to be here for a number of reasons. I certainly don't have to come out here and expound on all my credentials. I'm sure you took care of those.
I did indeed, sir.
I've been an admirer of yours for such a time, simply because you speak the truth. You might not like me, but you've seen me wrestle throughout my career. The basic reason I'm here today, and I'm going to stay here until something develops. This Lex Luger, if you're paying attention, fella, you made quite a reputation for yourself also. It doesn't matter if I'm in the Orient, in Canada, South America, the Middle East, or Europe. All I hear is this young upstart who's taking wrestling by storm. For some time, I know you're aware of it.
Yes.
I have put an issue out challenging Lex Luger anytime, any place, preferably here, because he's well known and well respected and loved here. Time and time again, I keep calling. Time and time again, those responsible say Lex Luger is already committed to another match, to another opponent. I want to make a challenge to you in your backyard, big tough guy. I'm here. I'm not leaving until you and I get in the ring. You're supposed to be great. I am great. You're supposed to be tough, but I am tough. You're supposed to be championship caliber. I am and have been and will be. If you've got any guts at all, any gumption, you'll sign a match with me.
Thank you so very much. The superstar, and I think he made his feelings abundantly clear. I'll be very curious. Lex Luger, of course, has the reputation of meeting any man, anytime, anywhere, under any terms. Be curious to see if he'll answer that challenge. Let me bring on the senior editor of Pro Wrestling Illustrated and wrestler, by the way, wrestler is currently in its 20th year. Wrestler magazine has sold over 15 million copies. It's the world's oldest, most established wrestling magazine. And its companion, Wrestler Annual, brings you the greatest compilation of all of the wrestlers each year. With me, of course, is my good friend Bill Apter.
Hello, Bill. Gordon Solie. Hello, buddy. Hello. Nice to see you.
Good to have you here.
In Florida.
I mentioned last week I knew that some kind of negotiations existed between Bob Roop and a major publishing firm. I didn't realize it was anything quite as prestigious as The Wrestler, and I might just point out a few of the series. In fact, the matter is, buddy, there's one here of a few years back that has your picture on the cover. I found that very interesting. There it is. This was February 1975 with Buddy Colt right here coming off the ropes. That was something that Buddy was pretty famous for. But let's get down to case hard facts. Bill, can you expound upon the purpose of this visit?
Okay, Gordon, as you know, X-Ray, this feature that we do every month in The Wrestler, is a feature where six great top stars examine top stars of the wrestling profession, six great veterans. And it's been announced recently that Gene Kiniski has been retired from the X-Ray panel, and our board of editors had a meeting several weeks ago, and it was unanimous that with 17 years of experience and knowledge behind him, that the only man to take Gene Kiniski's place properly would be the man to the right of me here, Mr. Bob Roop. Bob, congratulations. You're now on the Wrestler X-Ray panel.
Well, thank you, Bill. It's an honor. I've been involved with the ratings and making contracts for my good friend and associate, Lex Luger. And you know, I've sent in some ratings from this area for you, and I'm glad I came to your attention. It's an honor. It really is.
Well, as you know, Bob, being on the X-Ray panel, you'll also have to deal with some wrestlers that you're not too fond of as well.
Well, I'm in this situation, I'm impartial. I have to be, and that way I can go into, when I talk to people and make evaluations, I can go into dressing rooms and again, if the wrestlers leave me alone, believe me, I'll leave them alone.
So you can conduct yourself in a very non-hostile attitude.
If you give me some sort of identification card, maybe I'll hold it up when I go in the dressing room. Well, leave me alone.
What we need to do first, we have some papers here, contract signed in New York City by Peter King, our publisher. And right now we'd like to have you with Gordon Solie and Buddy Colt as witnesses sign on the dotted line here to be a member of the X-Ray panel. And allow me to photograph this, Bob.
Okay.
Well, certainly a very, very fine occasion here for Bob Roop. Of course, as you know, Bob Roop in his career wrestled in the Olympics. He was also All-Army champion. And certainly a pleasure to know that Bob Roop's expert analysis will be taken into consideration by Wrestler Magazine. And I can't think of a nicer honor coming to a nicer person. Bill, I certainly want to thank you very, very much. And may I just say that when you're looking for the very finest in wrestling publications, when you look at The Wrestler, you're looking at the oldest steady wrestling publication, over 15 million copies sold. Gentlemen, thanks again.
Thank you, Gordon.
It's a pleasure to have all of you with us. And again, our congratulations to Bob Roop, and we'll be right back. You know, as you've heard me say many times in the past, wrestling is a thinking man's sport. It's a game of human chess. And you've got to be able to use your brain power in order sometimes to outwit opponents. As you know, of course, there's been a problem between the fabulous ones, Stanley and Steve Kern, the new U.S. Tag Team Champions, and the shock troops headed up, of course, by this man, Sir Oliver Humperdinck. Well, an incident occurred a couple of weeks ago that I think is most interesting, and it will bear up in mind what I'm telling you about the thinking man situation. The Fabulous Ones had signed a match to go up against the Marauder and Pat Rose. Bass and his partner came out and challenged them. They accepted the challenge, but when it came time for the match, it was Pat Rose and the Marauder showing up. Now let's go to the beginning of that match, and I'll show you what I'm talking about in a thinking man situation.
The ball's not at the ball, Gantner.
All right, there you see now.
Yes, we this was these two were supposed to have been taking up the challenge for Gantner and Cowboy Ron Bass, but instead Pat Rose and the Marauder move in. And so the Fabulous Ones realize they're going to have to change their strategy. But they had indeed already worked out a strategy, as you're going to see in just a couple of moments. Now watch as Steve Kern jams the Marauder into that door and finally shoves the Marauder outside into the daylight. Now watch carefully. On the screen to your left, you'll see they knew something was going to happen. So Kern is waiting. He sees the door open, and it's Cowboy Ron Bass moving out. You notice he shuts the door. Now then, the door opens up. Here comes Gantner, Barry, and Kendall Windham shoving Gantner back inside the dressing room door and then putting their backs to it. So now you've got the situation with two on one against Cowboy Ron Bass. And it's Bass being beset upon by both of the Fabulous Ones. Pat Rose still outside. The Marauder, remind you, is outside. Now, Barry and Kendall leave. As you saw, Cowboy Ron Bass meeting at the Bull Gantner. Bass was not aware of the fact that Gantner couldn't get out. And so he and Gantner had at it for just a second verbally. But as you can see here, they got the pinfall. Now they bring the Marauder back in. And they put him back into the ring. And so the Fabulous Ones gave Mr. Bass a lesson and now take the match. They've got their victory. And may I just say that they handled things rather adroitly. They had their backup troops waiting. They gave everybody a little bit of a lesson. And all I can say is that it was well-deserved treatment on everybody's part. Now then, this led to a further situation with Barry Windham and Lex Luger taking on a tag team combination. And I don't think I have to tell you who they were. And we're going to take a look at that now. And we'll go back to that event as it occurred.
First from Boonesville, Missouri.
Gantner and Cowboy Ron Bass. They weren't waiting for the bell. They weren't waiting for anything. Barry Windham and Lex Luger exploding. And now the Bull and the Cowboy are in a lot of trouble here. Irish arm whip and both men hurtle into each other. And it is Lex Luger and Cowboy Ron Bass. Well, it's Lex Luger and Barry Windham, however. Pummeling at the Bull Gantner, got him outside the ring. And wait a minute, here comes the Cowboy Ron Bass back in there. And you've got a four-way melee going here. Lex Luger hurdles Cowboy Ron Bass outside the ring. Wait a second, Kendall Windham just came out there with a belt. Kendall Windham putting the belt to Cowboy Ron Bass.
Well, it seems like Kendall Windham wanted to come out here and replay them, but he's going with that belt again. Ron Bass right now wants to get back in that ring away from Kendall Windham. In the meantime, there is Barry and Lex Luger just pounding away at Ed Gantner.
Oh, the ninja just hit the deck. The ninja just hit the scene and he just jammed Kendall Windham into that ring close to now. The ninja charging into the ring and he's catching Barry Windham. And it is the ninja outside the ring. It's Sir Oliver Humperdinck pounding away on Kendall Windham. Barry Windham hurtled through the ropes. Lex Luger now. After the ninja, Cowboy Ron Bass, Barry Windham back into the ring. Lex Luger takes on the Bull Gantner. And it's Barry Windham hurtled outside the ring again. And meanwhile, they're 3-on-1 on Lex Luger. We've got 3-on-1. And now Barry Windham back in there. Pounding away, waiting. They're trying to, they're immobilizing Lex Luger. They've got that belt around his throat. And now we've got the ninja punishing Lex Luger. Cowboy Ron Bass punishing Luger is trapped in the throat. Barry Windham smashed to the ring post outside the ring. And Windham being shoved back in. Windham has been lacerated. Windham has been lacerated. It's Sir Oliver Humperdinck still pounding away at the Kendall Windham. And we've got complete chaos and bedlam going on here. And wait a minute. Lex Luger is broken free. Barry Windham is down. Shan Ron Bass leaving the scene.
Well, as you can see, that brings us now to the point. Certainly men like Bass and Ed the Bull Gantner and all should know what it's like to feel two or three on one, as they seem so prone to do at any opportunity. You saw the ninja in there, and for some of you, you may be curious about the ninja. Well, Kendo Nagasaki's attorneys in Houston have gotten a temporary injunction regarding some lose or leave town matches the ninja was involved in. It's a restraint of trade or what have you. In other words, there is a temporary injunction against the lose or leave situation, so the ninja is here, at least for the moment. Now, this all brings us around to the Florida Heavyweight Championship. As you know, it was just 2 weeks ago the Cuban Assassin planted that belt buckle in the eye of Kendall Windham, causing him some severe damage. Well, then Kendall Windham went back out, and as you saw at the beginning of the program, part of that Florida Championship match, Kendall Windham against Cowboy Ron Bass. Of course, that match was eventually halted because of the injury sustained by Kendall Windham to his eye socket. But rather than talk about that, I think now would be a good time to go to that tape in its entirety. We reviewed it earlier, and I think you'll see in a crystal clear manner the reason we say the Florida Championship is in doubt, although Cowboy Ron Bass holds it. So if we can, let's roll to that tape now, the Florida Championship, Kendall Windham and Cowboy Ron Bass. Can we have the tape? No, we don't have the tape. Well, wait a second. All right.
Well, anyway, we're waiting for the tape.
Disappear? Well, all right, I'll tell you what, Dave, can we... do you remember the one that we had scheduled for later with the superstar and Lex Luger and all?
Well, I think overheard Gordon saying the tape disappeared.
Okay, can we slide that up in its place? All right, we don't. For some reason, that tape has disappeared. I viewed it earlier. Now what we're seeing is a match, Barry Windham. As you can see, Lex Luger making the tag. Kareem Muhammad. And Ed the Bull, and of course, Lex Luger. And brother, you talk about two Goliaths in the ring. You've got them right there.
Well, I'll tell you, each man 270, 280 pounds, just solid muscle there. And between these two, it's going to be nip and tuck. Right now, it's obvious that Luger has the advantage, but not for long. There comes Kareem Muhammad, and in comes Barry Windham. I'll tell you, with four men like this, anything can happen at any time. Now it looks like Barry was down, but not for long. Right back on to Ed the Bull Gantner there.
We've got a situation here of one-on-one. Once again, Kareem Muhammad and Ed the Bull Gantner, the shock troops, managed, of course, by Sir Oliver Humperdinck. But Lex Luger and Barry Windham are proving themselves and beautiful lariat by Barry Windham. And Luger comes down. And now you got a situation here where it's reversed, two-on-one. And it's Luger and Barry Windham. They get the pinfall. They get the pinfall. But you see, once again, the philosophy of some competitors. They believe there's safety in numbers. They like to be able to stack the deck in their favor. They have that extra mean sadistic streak instead of the sense of fair play. Here comes the ninja charging into the ring. There you see the masked superstar. Now suddenly Ed the Bull Gantner back in action. And now the situation has been reversed again. The ninja now catching Luger, and so is the masked superstar. And you've got four on two in a situation here that indeed promises to be devastating, as both Barry Windham and Lex Luger, as outstanding an athlete as each of them is, you obviously cannot put up against the likes of men like Kareem Muhammad. Around 400 pounds crashing down across the chest of Lex Luger, the superstar, holding him helpless there. Meanwhile, the battle continues on the outside. And I think at this point in time, rather than for me to try and describe any further what's happening, I think that you see the essential viciousness on the part of men like Ed the Bull Gantner and Kareem Muhammad, the shock troops, the ninja, and of course we're also referring to the international superstar. We'll just let the action speak for themselves.
All
right, this match already in progress now. Chris Champion moving out against Mike Allen. And they have been going at it, hammer and tong. And it's Chris Champion. Beautiful drop kick. Allen powers out of it. Chris Champion moving in on him once again. Champion, who has an unblemished career record so far. Beautiful move by Allen. Catches the Champion, but the Champion retaliates. Champion a chop into the chest. Chris Champion misses that time, but caught him with a drop kick coming off the ropes. And again, Mike Allen powers out. Great match.
Well, I'll tell you, they have really been going nothing but action here. Big side through play. This could be lights out for Mike Allen. Nope, Mike Allen able to come out again. Chris Champion has been trying to make short work of Mike Allen because he has been challenging all of the top competitors. He caught him there for a big power slam. Once again, this could be it. He's trying to position him. I bet he comes off the top rope with a flying headbutt into the rib cage. When he does that, it practically crushes the rib cage, and that's what he's going for.
Champion all the way up and crashes down into Mike Allen. Caught him in the side and upper part of the rib cage. It is all over. And so Chris Champion remains undefeated. And there you see him, a very jubilant young man. And he notches up another victory. All right, Kareem Muhammad getting set to move out against Ricky Santana. Santana ducks away, gets on the back of that huge Kareem Muhammad. Muhammad turned that to his own advantage, however. And Kareem Muhammad is wasting no time here and trying to totally destroy young Rick Santana.
Well, I tell you, it kind of looked like a monkey on the back of a gorilla, because that Kareem Muhammad is as big as these gorillas, and 400 pounds, and that's going to crush his rib cage.
It's all over. It's all over. Kareem Muhammad in a sensationally quick win over Rick Santana.
John, I'd like to congratulate you on the great job you've been doing in professional wrestling for the short period of time that you have been a professional. But now, however, today, you went up against a mass superstar, one of the most devastating and awesome wrestlers in the world. This man has a world-renowned reputation, and this could have been your biggest test so far.
That's right. You know, my success is attributed to a lot of hard work and perseverance. And, you know, Mr. Matsuda, he did warn me about overmatching myself. You know, being that I'm young, but I feel that my anxiety, you know, maybe that did override the best of my judgment. But this by no means is showing Royal down. It's back to the gym, back to Mr. Matsuda, and I will return.
Let me say this, the only way to really get to the top in wrestling is to go after the top wrestlers, and you did just that, and so I think you did remarkably well, and once again, congratulations on a job well done.
Well, thank you.
I see Lex Luger over here waiting in the wings now. We don't really have him scheduled for an interview. Is there something you have in mind, Lex?
Excuse me, buddy Colt. I know I'm not scheduled to be on here today, but I'd just like to say something like that, some of the personal remarks and challenges made by this internationally renowned mass superstar. He's right about one thing. I do have a full schedule, a lot of commitments as a Southern Heavyweight Champion. But I promise you one thing, mass superstar. I'm going to make room for you. It's going to be one-on-one. It's going to be right here in the state of Florida. Thank you.
Well, superstar, I guess you have heard from Lex Luger. He seems like he's ready and willing to accept your challenge anywhere and at any time. So I'll tell you, you don't intimidate a man like Lex Luger too easily. Now let's go to the ring for another match coming right up.
Jerry Gray moving into the ring now, and he'll be going up against Tyree Pride, the Bahamas heavyweight champion. And that should be quite a match indeed. Tyree, and Gray charges him. Gray didn't wait for introductions, the bell, or anything else. It was Jerry Gray charging Tyree Pride and hurtling Tyree Pride over that top rope, and Pride slips around, catches him. Beautiful drop kick by Tyree Pride. Pride catches him again. A beautiful spin under takedown. Pride up in the air, another flying drop kick. It's Tyree Pride with another spin under takedown. And brother, he is perpetual motion.
Well, I'll tell you, that was some kind of a move when Tyree Pride went over that top rope, caught onto the ropes, came back in on another side of the ring, completely caught Jerry Gray off guard, and almost got matched. Now, that was quite a drop kick on the part of Jerry Gray. Yet Jerry Gray can't get up there. And now it looks like he has slowed Tyree Pride down to a slow crawl right here. Tyree's in a lot of trouble, Gordon.
Well, Tyree, Irish whip, and caught him with a lariat coming off the ropes. Jerry Gray down for a lateral press pinning combination, but Tyree Pride powers out. Irish whip, and it's Pride ducking away from it. Pride caught him coming in. Vertical body block. Caught Jerry Gray coming in. Excellent move on the part of Tyree Pride, and a fine victory for the Bahamas champion. Australian tag team event, Cowboy Ron Bass and Ed the Bull Gantner moving out against Mark Starr and Jim Backlund. One fall, television time remaining. And it's Bass punishing Starr right off the bat. Bass charges Starr, ducks to one side. Starr gets a full-arm drag and twist, makes the tag with Jim Backlund. Backlund moved in. And Backlund now punishing Cowboy Ron Bass. Bass, of course, the new Florida heavyweight champion. Set that title under a cloud.
Well, you know, Mark Starr and Jim Backlund right now have the right idea. They are trying to outmove and out-wrestle Ron Bass, knowing full well that Ron Bass has the power, strength, and wrestling experience. So they're going to do a lot of fast moves here. Now, that's a very quick way of countering a move. Just rake the man's eyes, bang his head into the turnbuckle, make short work of him, get it over with quick. Save your energy for a title match. And right now, with Ron Bass being the Florida heavyweight champion, that means he'll be getting challenges from the top contenders around the country trying to dethrone him.
Certainly no question about that. Ed the Bull Gantner moves in now, picks up the fallen body of... Wow! He brought him up with absolute ease, and that was wrestling some 220-odd pounds above his head. Ed the Bull Gantner just punishing. Jim Backlund again brings him up, another full body slam. Gantner in complete charge. Mark Starr still outside the ring. The tag is made. Cowboy Ron Bass moving in.
You know, I've been hearing that there is a cloud about the way that Ron Bass captured the Florida heavyweight title. I was talking to Ron Bass earlier, and he assured me that he defeated Kendall Windham for the title right in the middle of the ring with no interference from anybody at all, just a 1-2-3 clean victory. And I'm kind of inclined to believe that Ron Bass is a man of his word.
Well, all I can say is I reviewed the tape before it disappeared, and I certainly have a much different impression of that situation. And the man in the ring rack, Ed the Bull Gantner and Backlund turned halfway upside down, and Gantner now goes for the full Nelson. And Backlund is a complete, that's all. Ed the Bull Gantner and Cowboy Ron Bass, that's becoming an unholy duo, no question about it. They're approaching the table. By the way, this is the latest issue.
We don't want to hear about the latest issue. What? My picture's on the cover. I don't even want to hear about
it. All right.
What about the missing tape, Sully? You look pretty stupid out here. A few minutes ago with your mouth open, waiting for a tape to be played. What happened to it?
I don't know. I'm going to find out.
I want to know. That's why I'm the new Florida heavyweight champion. And when somebody else wins a major title, they come out here, you jump over and do backflips for them. You come out, you congratulate them, say, hey, man, a job well done. But now, I'm the Florida heavyweight champion. And you said, oh, well, Cowboy's the new Florida heavyweight champion. Let me tell you, I'm disappointed you didn't have a film. I'm disappointed all the people out there couldn't see my glorious victory, because now the title is on a man. It ain't on some little punk kid like that Kendall Windham. It's a real man for a chance. You know something? There ain't nothing I like better than busting Windhams, brother. And I busted a Windham bitch.
Wait a minute, hold up. Oh,
brother.
Well, I'll tell you what.
You ain't heard the last of me, believe
it. Oh, if I've ever seen deadly intensity in my life, I saw it when Kendall Windham came out, that big, tall Texan. walked out there, never said a word, and let Cowboy Ron Bass have it right slap across the face. Tell you one thing, that's one thing you don't do to, well, anyone, and particularly not Texans. Well, there's a rematch tonight in Sarasota. And brother, that is going to be a wild one, no question about that. Speaking on behalf of Buddy Colt, my thanks to Bill Apter for being with us. Till next week, so long.